Let's look at five entrepreneur stories to see how they use effectuation principles to create businesses. Let's start with Nerdy Academy. Nerdy Academy is a home tutoring service provider in Raipur in India. The founders wanted to set up an edtech venture, which would provide an online and mobile app platform for tutors and students. Unfortunately, they did not have either funding or access to technology. So, what did they do? They looked at what they had in hand. Since they were in college, they had many friends and other people in the network who wanted to earn more by giving tuition to school students. They also knew the parents of several school-going children who required such a service. All they did was bring these two together. By mapping people from the two pools, they were able to offer a one-to-one tutoring service, which was completely offline and focused on their town alone. Today, Nerdy Academy has over 200 tutors and about 1,000 students registered with them. This illustrates the effectuation principle, bird in hand. And this is common sense, isn't it? All it means is you start with what you have rather than hunting down for resources, technology, etc. Let's move on to entrepreneur Kevin DeWitt, based out of Oregon, USA. He started a venture called Agilix, which extracts crude oil from discarded plastic waste, thus helping to recycle plastic waste and putting it to good use. Today, it is a multi-million dollar company. But how did David start his venture? Well, he started based on what he had learned in his 20 years in the chemical industry. He saw an opportunity for making money out of trash by applying his knowledge in science. But he didn't start with a big bank. Rather, he set up a small and basic no-frill recycle unit, which grew over the years. To decide on how much money he could spend and how much more to invest, he asked himself one simple question: what could he afford to lose? This is the second effectuation principle and is known as affordable loss. Expert entrepreneurs can limit risk by understanding what they can afford to lose at each step. They do not look for large, all-or-nothing kind of opportunities. In other words, they do not gamble. Expert entrepreneurs also believe in the saying, when life gives you lemons, make lemonade. That's what George Crumb did. At the time, he was a chef in an elegant New York resort and was facing flak over his French fries, which his guests complained were too thick and not crispy enough. So, to play a joke on them, he cut his fries so thin that people wouldn't be able to eat them with a fork. And lo and behold, potato chips were born. This is the third principle of effectuation, the lemonade principle. The mantra is to leverage contingencies and turn unpleasant surprises, in other words, problems, into new opportunities. But leveraging contingencies alone is not enough to make your venture a success. Leveraging your networks and forming strategic partnerships is equally important. Who hasn't heard of PayPal? When PayPal discovered that they were losing out on customers because there were some websites that did not accept PayPal payments directly, they formed a partnership with MasterCard. This led to the development and launch of VeriSign, a PayPal secure card service that allows customers to make payments on websites that do not accept PayPal directly by generating a unique single-use MasterCard number for each checkout. Again, in 2012, PayPal announced its partnership with Discover Card to enter the offline retail market, where they could use Discover Card's existing network across 7 million stores. This is the essence of the fourth effectuation principle, the patchwork quilt or crazy quilt. Here, entrepreneurs collaborate with various types of partners who are willing to pre-commit rather than search for potential partners who might not be available or be as motivated. Networking is the mantra here. Accumulate as many stakeholders to create the future and reduce uncertainty. Entrepreneurs are always looking to reduce uncertainties, and to do that, they want to write their own future and be their own bosses. That's what Belgium's Els van Houten, CEO of Roos Productions, did. She started Dress Your Doll, a totally unique concept where children could make clothes for their Barbies themselves. When she found significant growth opportunities for Dress Your Doll in the US market, a market with a dramatically different retail network, she seized that opportunity and then started their own webshop for US customers without second thoughts. She became her own pilot. This is the fifth principle of effectuation, the pilot in the plane. Where the entrepreneurs don't feel the need to predict the future as long as they control it and steer their own path. So, are you ready to steer your own aircraft? What are you waiting for? Get ready, get going.